Hello children. In the previous sessions of the physics class, we discussed about the uniform and non-uniform motions, what is velocity, what is acceleration, what are its formulas, like how to find out velocity and how to find out acceleration. And in the previous class, we also studied what are uniform and non-uniform acceleration as well. In today's class, children, let us study about the graphical representation of motion. Graphical representation of motion means you have been used to the graph. So what they say is this: whenever you represent or any data in the graph, so they say it as the graphical representation. Maybe in any matter, like see, if at all, if you see the weather forecasting for a month in your in the internet, like if you check in the Google or the weather forecast of this whole week, if you want to check, how do they show? Will they show Monday, this date, this was the temperature, it was cloudy, it was sunny, it was rainy? Will they represent like that? No, they show the graphical representation. Even in the case of cricket, children, to know the strike rate, to know the run rate, with what speed the ball is, with what velocity the ball, the ball was bound, like that, everything to check, the usually represent it with the graphical representation. Even in the stock market, if at all you observe whether there is increase in the amount or decrease in the amount of shares, it is regarding the shares, all that is usually represented by using this graphical representation. So this graphical representation generally is a, what we say, it is a convenient method of giving some information to someone. It is a convenient method. So even if at all you plot the graph of the marks you score right from FA1, FA2, FA3, SA1 and SA2. So if you plot the graph, so if at all you score more like that on x-axis, y-axis this month, or the FA1, FA2, FA3 along one axis, and the total marks scored along one axis, and you keep on plotting, you can know the level, whether you have increased your marks is increased, your percentage is increased, you are improving in studies or not. FA1, if you have scored more, FA2, you may score less due to some reason. FA3, FA4, again it may rise up like that. So graphical representation is the clear and the convenient method of conveying the information to anyone. So for this case of this motion also, what we studied about this uniform and non-uniform motion, non-uniform and uniform velocity, uniform and non-uniform acceleration, if at all we represent it in the form of graph, graphically if we represent them, then it will be the best way or best method to understand. See, we have been studying what is uniform velocity or uniform acceleration. If I tell you, what you say? Stand up and say what you, if at all the body travels, covers equal distances in equal interval of time, then we say the body is said to undergo the uniform motion. If the body is covering unequal distances in unequal interval of time, then we say that it is non-uniform velocity or acceleration. This is what we do. But that simply saying this, if you show it graphically by drawing the graph, whether the velocity is increasing, decreasing, it is constant or what. So if you represent, it is the easiest and the better way to understand the data here. So children, so looking in your textbook, there are many graphs given, some markings and all as there. Please don't get confused looking at that. So whatever I am teaching you now, if you understand this, that is far enough. Now first see, graphical representation of motion. What type of motion? Uniform motion and non-uniform motion with respect to velocity and with respect to acceleration we should study today. Now children, first graph what I plotted, if you can see, it is the distance time graph. In your textbook, children, what they have given is, they have literally given the graph sheet with small that squares and all that markings. So you need not draw all that when you are writing in exam. So simply if you draw a simple representation of this graph is fine. First we shall check the distance time graph. There are two types of graph we are learning today, children. One is distance time graph, the other is velocity time graph. Distance time graph, see, in the test or exam, we may ask you draw the DT graph. DT means what? distance time graph. VT graph means velocity time graph. So you should know its short form as well. So first we shall study the distance time graph. Distance time graph or the DT graph for two cases. One is uniform speed, the other is non-uniform speed. So before understanding the graph, let us study the once again repeat the definition of what is uniform speed or uniform motion of the body. If at all the body, suppose we say a car is starting to move. If at all the car is covering equal distances in equal interval of time, then we say the car is undergoing uniform motion. It is moving with uniform motion. Suppose if at all the car starts, see here, this is the graph chart. So you know graph consists of, let us wait for the disturbance to go. Okay, so now in the first DT graph, children, as you know, graph means you have two axes, right? One is x axis, other is y axis. This horizontal line is x axis, vertical line is y axis. Along x axis, any graph you plot, children, this you should remember. Any graph DT, VT for uniform, non-uniform, whatever you plot, x axis always represent time. So it is on our convenience, time may be in minutes, may be in seconds, or may be in an hour. So in hours. So here, thing you need to keep in mind is along x axis time is plotted and along y axis distance is plotted in case of this distance time graph or the DT graph. So if you can see, time is plotted along x axis and distance in meter, you should write the unit as well, whichever physical quantity you are writing in the bracket, you should mention its unit as well. So time in minutes in this particular graph, distance will be in terms of meter. So here 20, 40, 60, 80, 100, 120, in difference of 20 it goes, children. So we can say x axis 1 centimeter is 20 minutes. In 20 minutes, if at all it covers, so in the y axis you have 10, 20, 30, 40, distance in meter, 10 meter, 20 meter, 30 meter, 40 meter, like that it goes. So if at all in the span of 20 minutes, say the car is covering distance of 10 meter, next in the span of 20 minutes, 20 meter, sorry, 40 minutes, 20 meter, 60 minutes, 30 meter, 80 minutes, 40 meter, like that. It is covering equal distance and equal interval of time. If this 20, 40, 60, 10, 20, 30 is confusing to you, children, no problem. It is not mandatory that you should mention 20, 40, 60, 80 only. Since it was there in the textbook, I thought of choosing the same. Even you can choose time to be 10, 20, 30, 40, 50, 60. Here also 10, 20, 30, 40, the distance, no problem. So, suppose say the car covers 10 meters in 10 minutes. In 10 minutes, the car is covering distance of 10 meter. In 20 minutes, 20 meter. 30 minutes, 30 meter. 40 minutes, 40 meter. 50 minutes, 50 meter, like that. In every 10 minutes of span, it is covering distance of 10 meter. Means, here now we get the meaning for the definition. It covers equal in the distances and equal interval of time, children. So this is how when you join all those points, what you get is a straight line like this. Straight line, simply you cannot draw a straight line. It should be a straight line passing through the origin. It is a straight line passing through the origin. So this graph represents the distance time graph for a uniform motion of a body, or you know, for a body traveling with uniform speed. Both are same. So first what we learned is the DT graph for the uniform motion of the body, where the body traveling, here we consider the example of a car. The car covers equal distance in equal intervals of time. Next, children, we have DT graph for the non-uniform speed or non-uniform motion. If at all the body is not covering equal distances in equal interval of time, then we say the body is said to possess the uniform motion. Non-uniform motion. In this graph only, if you consider, see here we studied that for 10 meter it is covering, means 20 minutes, 20 kilometer distance. Then we have taken in meter, so let me say in terms of meter itself. 30 minutes, 30 meter, 40 minutes, 40 meter. If at all it is not happening, so initially when the car started, when you start the car from the house until you reach the main road, there will be no traffic and you can maintain the speed. So we say for in 10 minutes you cover distance of 10 meter. After going to the main road also, there was no much traffic, so you were able to maintain the speed. Means in next span of 10 minutes, that is 10 plus 10, 20 minutes, you are covering a distance of 20 meter. After traveling for 20 minutes, suppose you say you get a signal, you need to stop your car. Again, when you start, you cannot continue with the same speed. Yes, no? Your speed of the car will be at rest when you stop your car in the signal. And when you, again, when the green signal comes, when you start moving the car, you cannot start with 10 kilometers speed at a time, no? You slightly increase the speed. So, then this speed varied. So, between the span of 20 to 30 minutes, the distance covered may be 5 kilometers or 3 kilometer or 2 kilometer. Again, when you start moving, there will be a hump. So you cannot go with same speed on the hump. What happens? What will happen if you suddenly pass the car on the jump? The person sitting inside will also jump in the car and hurt your head. Yes, no? So whenever you get the hump in the road, you have to apply the brake in the sense, not stop, slow down your car. Cross the hump slowly and again you can increase the speed. So while doing so also, in that span of 5 minutes, again the speed of your car is decreased. Like this, the body cannot cover this equal distance in equal interval of time. Then it is said to possess this non-uniform acceleration. Look here, children, again for this DT graph or the distance time graph for non-uniform motion also, along x-axis, this doesn't change for any graph. X-axis time always. If at all it is DT graph, along y-axis you will plot distance. If it is VT graph, that is velocity graph, along y-axis you will plot velocity. That is the only difference. X-axis is always time. So, time is plotted here. 2, 4, 6, 8, 10. In terms of that, the time is chosen in seconds here. In the previous graph, time was in terms of minutes. Here, time is in terms of seconds. Again, in the y-axis, distance is in terms of meter here. See, 5, 10, 15, 20, etc. Here, in 2 seconds, car may cover distance of 5 meter. In 3 seconds, it may cover 7 meters, 4 kilometers, 15 meters. There was no traffic and suppose if at all the car is traveling in the highway, then for 4 meter, it can 4 seconds, it can even travel a distance of some 8 meters, say it can go up to 8 meter, 10 meter, like that. So usually in highways means you go with high speed, minimum 60 to 70 or 80 kilometers, sometimes 100, 120 kilometers speed also you go. Yes, no? So here the graph is not straight as in case of uniform motion. See, it is changing. You can see the curve here. So this is how you represent the distance time graph of a non-uniform motion graphically. If at all, see the question how it will be asked in test or exam also, I'll tell you. Okay, na? Draw the distance time graph or DT graph for the non-uniform motion of the body. That's all the question will be given to you. So what you do, choosing scale is your choice, children. But along x-axis you will mention time, along y-axis you will mention the distance. And if at all it asked for uniform, non-uniform motion was asked, no? So you should not draw a straight line. You will draw a line and give a curve like this. Means it is not covering equal distance at equal interval of time. So that is how you represent. Always the line should start from origin, children. If at all DT graph for uniform motion was asked, means a straight line passing through the origin. Straight line in the graph, children, which is passing through origin, always. Not only in this case, further if you study in mathematics also, you will plot this. You have plotted, no, the linear equation. If at all you get straight line passing through the origin, like that only for linear equations. Any graph, even in 10th you will study, children. So directly proportional and inversely proportional concept we have learned. Now, if one term increases, other also if it increases, directly proportional. If one increase, one decrease, inversely proportional. Here, if distance is increasing, time also will increase. Time decreases, distance also decreases. So they are directly proportional, means you will get a linear graph. Linear graph means a straight line graph which is passing through the origin. So that is uniform speed. Non-uniform speed means you will represent the graph, curved graph like this. Only thing you have to keep in mind here is, children, which you will draw the linear graph, for which you will draw the curved graph. That you need to keep in mind. Next, we shall study about the VT or the velocity time graph, children. So this velocity time graph also, as I said, you x-axis and y-axis and intersection point is origin O. For the velocity time graph also, along x-axis time is plotted. If you see, velocity time graph for uniform motion we are drawing here. So in your textbook they have considered the example of a car traveling in a straight line with uniform speed or velocity. So if you consider that, children, here time is expressed in terms of hours. Here we saw it expressing in terms of minute, here in seconds, but here it is in terms of hours. But time along x-axis, that is important. Along y-axis the distance was plotted, since it was VT graph. Since it is VT graph, we are plotting velocity and unit is meter per second. That only you should write along y-axis. So for a car traveling with uniform speed in a straight line, how do you get the graph? Is you get the line which is parallel to the x-axis. VT graph for the body traveling with uniform velocity. How do you get the graph? Is it is a straight line which is parallel to the x-axis, children. See, this is a straight road. Yes, no, the car is traveling in the straight road. See, here for uniform, the line was passing through origin. Why? For every interval of time, the distance kept changing. Here what is happening? Since the car is traveling in the straight road and we are representing now velocity, what is velocity? Rate of change of speed. See, you can hear the sound of the lorry now. If you are sensitive, you can hear the sound. So do you think it is going in uniform motion or non-uniform motion? See, the road, it has humps and that, and also it cannot travel with uniform speed. No? It is moving with uniform velocity. So this is not the graph for that. This is the graph which represents the uniform velocity of the body. So the graph is a straight line which is parallel to x-axis, children. Next, we studied about uniform and non-uniform acceleration as well. So VT graph for uniform acceleration means it is similar to that of the graph DT graph for uniform speed or uniform motion. Here for uniform acceleration also, you get a straight line which is passing through the origin, a linear graph. Here also along x-axis time is mentioned in seconds, and along y-axis, since velocity time graph here in terms of meter per second it was represented, here it is in terms of kilometer per hour. So in 5 seconds 10 kilometer per hour speed it is going in. 10 in the next 5 seconds it is increasing the speed of the car, means it is, the car is moving with now 20 kilometer per hour speed. 15 seconds 30 kilometer per hour speed. 20 seconds 40 kilometer per hour speed. 25 seconds 30 kilometer per hour speed, like this. It is covering equal distances. It is covering equal distances in equal interval of time. Means it is again the uniform acceleration. It is moving with it is moving with same speed at different intervals of time. Means it is called uniform acceleration, children. So these are the four main graphs which you need to know. So in your textbook, after every graph, some derivations are there, children. Don't worry about all that. What I want you to do is just go through it once. We will be studying about the equations of motion. So if you remember the equations of motion, which you already know, you have studied in 8th standard also. So that, if you remember, it is enough. Derivation not required. It is there in the textbook. So I am making you clear again, it will not be asked in test or exam also. If at all graphical representation is asked, I said no, how the question will be. You can expect, draw the DT graph for uniform motion of the DT graph or VT graph. This confusion you should not make in test or exam. DT graph means in the, for uniform, it is the straight line passing through the origin. If it is non-uniform motion, you will get a curve like this. In case of velocity time graph, we studied it for uniform velocity. For uniform velocity, here if you consider the car which is moving in a straight line, you will get a graph which is parallel to x-axis. As far as VT graph for uniform acceleration is concerned, again you get the similar graph like that of the DT graph for the uniform motion. The same graph for uniform acceleration also. For VT graph for uniform acceleration means again you will get a straight line, that is a linear graph which is passing through the origin. These are the four main graphs that you need to keep in your mind, children. So in your textbook, children, page number 104, you have this graphical representation of motion. You have distance time graph and this graph, which is the first graph which we studied. They have made few markings at which second, how many meter like that, and they have arrived simply at one what one formula, V is S2 minus S1 by T2 minus T1. These are the things which they are doing in order to arrive at the equations of motion. Since I said the derivation is not there, okay, fine, don't worry of it for now. Now, what I wanted to say you is, here, see, this is the graph what we got shows us that the distance travelled by the object is directly proportional to time taken. I said, you know, if at all you are getting linear graph, it means the two quantities what you are plotting are directly proportional to each other. Thus, for uniform speed, a graph of distance travelled against straight line as shown in the figure is a straight line that they have given. In the next paragraph, they have mentioned about the T2 and T3 and all. Don't worry on that for now. Next graph, figure 8.4, children, you have distance time graph for a car moving with non-uniform speed. You have this graph in your textbook, so just go through it and read the explanation given there. Next you have the velocity time graph. The variation in velocity with time for an object moving in a straight line can be represented by a velocity time graph. In this graph, time is represented along x-axis and velocity is represented along y-axis. If the object moves at uniform velocity, the height of its velocity time graph will not change with time. So you may, I said, you know, forgot to tell that point to you. Here in case of uniform DT graph, uniform speed, and in case of uniform acceleration, we are getting a straight line which is passing through origin. But this velocity time graph for uniform velocity is a bit different. We are getting a straight line, but not starting from the origin, but the line is parallel to the x-axis. That explanation is given here to you, children, in page 105. If the object moves at uniform velocity, the height of its velocity time graph will change with time. It will be a straight line parallel to the x-axis. Hence, it is the line which is parallel to the x-axis, children. Next, some calculation part is there, so you can just go through it. And it is not that very important. And next, if you come to the next page, children, thus for all uniformly accelerated motion, the VT graph is a straight line that you need to keep in mind. In the next page, you have, children, velocity time graph for a car moving with uniform acceleration. That is what we learned here. It is just the straight line. So what they have done is, after drawing, see, they have just made the marking here like this, and this area is being shaded. So why this is done in any of the graphs you see here is the shaded part. If you want to clearly say this from distance, so in time 10 to 220 seconds, the distance increased is, the speed increases from 20 km to 40 km per hour. If at all you want to say particularly like that, children, this markings and shadings will be required. So they have chosen, now if you join this, you get triangle here. This is the rectangle. Apply the area formula for a triangle, rectangle, all that is there. Don't worry of all that for now. Next, children. Yes, you go through the textbook once. That is what the explanation is given. Next, you have equations of motion by graphical method. When the object moves along a straight line with uniform acceleration, it is possible to relate its velocity, acceleration during motion and the distance covered by it in certain time interval by a set of equations of motion. There are three such equations of motion. So you all know those equations, my children. V is equal to u plus at, s is equal to ut plus half at square, and v square minus u square is equal to 2as. These are the three main equations of motion which you have. Next, 8.5.1 is, children, equation for velocity time graph relation. So in this they have derived v is equal to u plus at formula. Next, equation for position time relation, there they have arrived at s is equal to ut plus half at square formula. And next, equation for position velocity relation, in that they have arrived at 2as is v square minus u square is equal to 2as. This equation of motion, children. So as I said, you derivation no need to study. Just remember the main equations of motion and these four graphs mainly. That is enough. Next, you have, children, few exemplar problems based on this equation of motion. Before solving that, let us study about the last topic of this lesson, that is uniform circular motion. And before that, I want to tell you something, children. I have already sent you the notes of this lesson. Finally, 10 question answers were there. Many of you are asking me doubts of how to plot this graph. Mainly you have in question number 6 and 8 in your textbook. In the question, if at all graph is there, you need not write it in your classwork. And if at all you need to plot the graph in the answer, I said you take the graph sheet, cut it as much as required, plot whatever it is roughly like this. Roughly means wherever you want the markings, don't do. In equal interval, scale should be chosen correctly, okay? So choose some rough scale, whichever you want. I have sent you the answer as well. Roughly you plot and paste that small piece of graph sheet in the classwork itself, children. Hope your doubt is clear. So before solving the exemplar problems on this topic or equations of motion, now let us study what is uniform circular motion. After studying about, we have been studying about uniform and non-uniform motion of a body, for the body travelling in straight line. What if the body is in circular motion? If it is rotating, how do you find out whether it is uniform or non-uniform motion? Let us discuss it now.